Before I knew it, I too was a simp for the Darkling. Hi guys. So it's extremely rainy and dark outside, and I had to use a lot of lights to get this to kind of look decent. So you could almost say that I'm a light summoner or a sun summoner. What was she again? So judging by the title, you can already tell what we're going to be discussing today. I did it. I finally did it. People finally convinced me to start reading this series. Today we're going to be talking about the Shadow and Bone book, which is the first book in the Shadow and Bone trilogy and the whole Grisha verse. I don't actually know how to pronounce it. I, for one thing, when I read this book for the first time, I always thought that Grisha was the author's name for some reason. Everyone always talked about the Grisha verse, and I was like, oh yeah, this writer called Grisha, I don't fucking know. So I read the first book in the Shadow and Bone trilogy by Leigh Bardugo. You know who I'm talking about. This trilogy has been all over YouTube, all over Instagram. I think her Six of Crows series is a bit more popular or a bit more well-loved, I'm not sure. But I thought I'd start off with this one. Some choices were made in this book, let me tell you. So if you don't know, it's a young adult fantasy series. Do I have to give a quick summary? It's about this girl called Alina, and she has some magical powers, and she gets involved in this weird cult-like group called the Grishas. The Grisha. It's just called the Grisha, and they're all the Grisha. Yeah, so I'm just going to give a quick review of the first book. I'm probably going to continue because people keep bugging me about it, and you know, I'm kind of curious now. On Goodreads, I gave it 3 out of 5 stars. I was really torn about this, and I also wrote down why, like my reasoning for this. It was very difficult because I do understand that this is a book series that is young adult, so its target demographic is not me. I'm a little too old and bitter to be enjoying this type of, to really be, like, let's just say, to really love this type of story. I think if I would have been a teenager reading this, I would have been so into this. This writer really understood, like, what teenagers want to read, and she fully went for it. There were some enjoyable parts, and I am, like, kind of curious. It's a light and easy read, so why not? I am curious what's going to happen next. In the series. Yeah, like I said, being a young adult novel, it has a lot of these a bit tired, cliche stereotypes going on in terms of character, in terms of... It's very much tick off the boxes, like a female protagonist who kicks ass but actually doesn't have that much character going on. Tick, creepy villain dude who is like basically Russian Tom Riddle, who wants her to come over to the dark side of the force. I don't fucking know. Tick. Female best friend. Tick. Male best friend that she's known on her all her life, and they're secretly also in love with each other. Tick. I mean, it ticks off all the boxes. The best characters are, without a doubt, so far, after reading the first book, are Zhenya. I don't actually know how people will actually pronounce it in English. If this is supposed to be the Russian name, this is actually a Russian name, it's Zhenya, it's my name, so that's why I'm so excited. Best character. You don't understand how difficult it is with my name. Like, I have never read about a character with my name, or seen a character with my name, unless it's probably something, like, actually from Russia. But, yeah, so I was excited as fuck. And also, she was kind of more interesting than Alina. Alina also suffered from that main character curse, where all the side characters are more interesting than her. or maybe not all side characters, but a lot of the side characters are more interesting than her. Oh, I would have preferred if Virginia was the lead, to be honest. Can we get like a book about her? Yeah? Because I like her, she's cool. And then the Darkling, he is doing some stuff, he's scheming, he's like the descriptions we got for him is that he has dark hair, he's really fucking old but looks young, and he has like long pale fingers, I don't fucking know. So he's basically Tom Riddle or Nosferatu. Is that you?
Nosferatu!
Yeah, he has dark hair and is really, really old. So if that ain't my type, I don't know what is, to be honest. Is this the Darkling? Is this like the Darkling you all of you all simping over? Same, to be honest. Before I knew it, I too was a simp for the Darkling. Yeah, Alina being this basic YA character also means that she's really pretty. She's pretty enough that every male character falls in love with her. But she thinks of herself as two of the most unattractive things ever. She suffers from the two most unattractive physicalities you can possibly have. She is too pale and tired looking. And she is really thin. She's like model thin, you know? She's like really skinny. It's so tragic. She's so thin and ugly, but everyone is in love with her. It's like... At first I was like, is the Darkling really a villain? Because he kept being like all reasonable and nice. And I was like, is this just one of those things that we have to accept? Because he hasn't... We were like 2/3 of the book in and he hasn't done anything. And then... I was like, you know what? I'm rooting for the Darkling. I don't know. He just seems like a chill dude. And just as I thought that, he literally kissed this underage girl. I don't fucking know how old she is, actually. He literally kissed this girl, Alina. And I was like, please, Mr. Darkling. No, I was rooting for you. We were all rooting for you. It all went to shit. And then, but then, she was into it all of a sudden. And even though she's in love with this dude she's known all her life, her best friend, all of a sudden she was just making out with the Darkling. And I was like, well, I guess we're doing this now. That was probably the most interesting thing. Like, the relationship between Alina and the Darkling is probably what we're all here for, let's be honest. But figuring as this is like your typical YA trilogy, I'm going to go out on a limb and say that she is not actually going to join him to the dark side, which... What's the point otherwise? What's the point? What's the point if you're not going to join some shady guy with his quest for world domination? So I did enjoy that. I enjoyed the shady romance that's going on between her and the Darkling. I just wish she was more of an interesting character. But now that I think about it, like, what is she actually? Like, what are these powers supposed to be? Like, he makes, like, shadows and stuff, I guess? He has, like, shadows come out of his hands or whatever. And she, like, summons really bright lights. So she has about the same powers as like a really strong lamp. Anyway, yeah, I just wish she was more of an interesting character. You know, I am kind of enjoying this. Like I said, it's a nice and easy light read. I'm curious what's going to happen next, even though it's probably not going to go the way that I want it to go. Which, you know, that's fine, that's cool, let's just suffer, let's just all suffer together, and let's wait for the Netflix series to come out. Very curious about that one. So, I have to read Siege and Storm next, and then Rising Rune or something. Runes Rising. I don't know. Anyway, Let me know in the comments what you thought, if you have actually read this book or this trilogy.